paper, namely asset inequalities among farm households in rural Punjab, which is basically a primary survey based paper. This paper uses primary data collected through a detailed schedule from 325 households involved in agriculture operations from 23 villages of Punjab. Results: an average Punjabi household owns durable assets worth ₹6.5 lakh. The durable assets reflect the socio-economic status of household. The structure of assets shows that household durables predominate at all surveyed category. Within the farming community, the average value of all the durable assets increases with the increase in farm size. A residential building is the most valuable asset, accounting for around 4/5 of the total household asset across the different categories. The durable assets are possessed maximum by the large farmers and minimum by the agricultural labor category. The per capita value of household durable asset is around 4 lakhs for the large farmer category, whereas agricultural labor category owns household durable assets worth only 1/10 of the large farm category. The respondent of medium farm category have per capita value of farm asset worth nearly half of the large farmer asset. Agricultural labor category assets are worth only 0.089% of the large farmer asset. The farm assets other than land account for only 1/10 of total asset value of an average sample rural household. The livestock asset value is the highest for large farmer category and lowest for agricultural labor. The per capita value of household durable assets clearly reflect that large and medium farm categories are maintaining a comparatively better level of living than those under the other household categories. The socio-economic condition of the agricultural laborers is deeply miserable. The analysis of per capita value of farm assets clearly shows that the large and medium farmer category are relatively better placed as compared to the marginal and small farmer category due to their large size of holding. Economists agree on the fact that inequalities of income and assets have harmful economic effects. Increased inequality with top heavy income distribution harmful for economic growth, as the rich tend to spend a smaller fraction of their income than the poor, which can slow economic growth. Thus, decreasing the inequality level also tend to promote higher and more stable development process, which in turn has significant impact on the employment generation, reduction of poverty, and have a smooth and sustainable development of agriculture sector. Decreasing the inequality levels also tend to promote higher and more stable development process, which in turn has significant impact on employment generation, reduction of poverty, and have a smooth and sustainable development of agriculture sector. Policymakers should focus on improving land titles and promoting equality in income and land distribution toward the country. There is a need to improve labor standards in rural sector for agriculture sustainability. Livestock sector can be helpful if better policy is made and provided with advanced and affordable technology. Punjab must bring together its progressively productive and modern agriculture system with environmental conservation, social equality, and poverty alleviation in rural areas.
Thank you. So he has touched poverty in the rural areas. So he emphasized that development is directly linked with environmentalization, poverty reduction, and sustainability of agriculture. So we should take steps that he has suggested, and so that disparity or inequality is decreased, so that we go towards development. Thank you very much. Its magnitude and sources in Punjab agriculture. It's by Rohan Saini and Rajkumar.